Hello friends, my name is Haris and you're watching Tech Reel. So today I'm going to talk about how you can save your battery on the iOS 14 update from Apple. So I'm going to talk about 25 tips and tricks here. So the first thing is the widgets. As you can see, you have multiple widgets now from Apple, you know, which will really help you track each and everything at a one shot. But I'm not sure if you really need all these widgets, right? So at the left hand side, you can see there are so many widgets. So what you can do is you can come to the bottom of the phone and click on the edit button, and you can just remove whatever is not needed. So you can just keep those widgets, what is really needed and you know what is really necessary for you to have a track of. So as you can see, if you don't need reminders, you know, you can just go ahead and remove it. So like this, you can remove all the widgets which are not required. Also, if you see, we have a stack option here, right? So you can see a lot of things here on the widget. So you can just go to edit here, edit stack. So you can see these things are already there in the stack, and you can probably change the widgets to whatever is needed, and you can just see the updates. So just ensure that whatever is needed, only those widgets are on the screen. This will really preserve your battery and will help, because at the background you will be able to see all the refresh going on, and these widgets will be working 24/7. So definitely it's going to consume a lot of battery. So the second thing what I want to tell is, if you go to settings and if you go to accessibility, and if you come down, right, you have something called sound recognition. So if at all this is on, so what happens is we have different sounds here, like fire. I'll take an example of doorbell. So if your doorbell is on, if you keep this on, right, what happens is if someone rings your doorbell, your iPhone will give you a notification that your doorbell has been rung. So what happens is your microphone will work 24/7, and if there is any sound of the doorbell, it will notify you that your doorbell has rung, and this will really consume a lot of battery again. So what I would suggest you is, only if you need this, then you can use this. If not, I suggest you just turn this off. And the third thing what I want to show you is, if at all you go to music, right, in music what happens is you have something called motion. So usually when you play your favorite music or soundtracks, it will have all the motion animation going on. So if at all you don't need any poster animation or, you know, any images which are getting transitioned, you can just switch it off. Or if you are at home, if you are using Wi-Fi, then I would suggest you use Wi-Fi only. So basically, to gain good battery backup, I suggest you keep it off, and this will really help you save your battery. So this is one more thing. So the other thing what I would want to say you is, go to accessibility, and then what you can do is you just need to go to Siri here, and you have something called always listen for Hey Siri. So if at all you really rely on Siri for each and everything, then probably you can keep it on, or I would suggest, you know, you just turn it off, and this will really help you again save your battery. So the next thing is I would go to the notifications. So usually you have a lot of applications here, and I would really suggest whatever applications, you know, you really use and which you really want to get notified on, you just like example, if at all, you know, like Cricbuzz. So now, you know, cricket is something, you know, which huge fans like to watch the score and all. So we also have Indian Premier League going on. So if you want timely notifications, allow the notifications, or I would suggest you just switch off the notifications, and you can just manage whatever application you want, you know, to be notified. And this will really conserve your battery, and you will get some good power consumption as well, so which will really help you have a good battery backup again. So the next thing is what I want to tell you is, go to the sound section, sound and haptics. So usually when you're riding or when you're driving, definitely if your phone is in your pocket, and you know, if you cannot hear, if there's a loud noise, you would definitely need a vibrate, so you can use vibration. But what I would suggest you is, if you want again a good battery backup, then probably, you know, just remove the vibration section here. You know, that will really help you save your battery again. So the next thing what I would want to say you is about the background app refresh. So go to general, background app refresh. So as you can see, these all applications will be running in the background, and you'll be having the background refresh going on at the back end. So whichever application is really not needed in the background, you can just switch them off. Like example, probably I'll take some application as Google Photos, which is really not needed. So if you don't want it, you can turn it off. So this will again help you save your battery. The next thing is go to display and brightness, and you have something called race to wake. So whenever you pick your phone from the table or from the bed, so what happens is your phone will get awake because of lifting the phone. So if you really don't need it, you can probably just switch it off, and this will again help you save your battery. So the next thing what I'm going to talk about is you can go to accessibility again. So in this you have something called motion. So in the motion section you have something called reduce motion. So this is nothing but which helps you reduce the interface, and there is some motion effects in some applications which will help you track all of this, and will probably use a lot of battery. So you can just switch off the reduce motion option, and which will again give you a lot of battery backup. So the next thing is again on the accessibility, you will go to touch, and you have something called tap to wake. So wake the screen when you tap the display. So when you tap, the display will get awake, right? So if you don't need this, again you can probably switch it off, which will again help you conserve your battery. So this is one of the options. And the next thing what I want to tell you is about the location services. This is a very important thing what I'm going to talk about now. So I'm sorry, I'm getting some notifications. Pardon me for that. So in the location, what you can do is you can probably manage your location very efficiently. If at all you don't want all the applications to use your location each and every time, what you can do is you can just set as while using, or you can just set as ask. So if you see something here called Google Maps, only if you are using the maps, it will use the location. If at all, it will not use your location. So based on what your applications are on your mobile phone, I would suggest you really go to the location services and just turn it off wherever you don't need any location to be tracked. So this will really help you conserve your battery again. So the next thing is you have something called system services. Just a second. Yeah, it's here. So here, like example, Apple Pay merchant identification. If at all you're in a country where Apple Pay is not supported, you can turn it off. So a lot of things are there here which will really conserve your battery. So as you see, the battery is low on my phone. So this is a really important video, guys. So please watch it completely. So whatever you don't need here, so what you can do is you can just turn it off, which will really help you update your battery again. So the next thing what I'm going to talk about is about the privacy feature again. So in the privacy section in the Bluetooth, what you can do is if at all you really don't need these apps to access your Bluetooth, you can just turn it off. So usually when you are playing a video on YouTube, if you want to cast it, if you have an Android TV, then definitely you will need the Bluetooth to be on, because the sharing will not work. So in the similar fashion, if you need all the applications to track and have a Bluetooth turn on, so you can probably turn it on, or else I prefer you just turn it off. So this is again one of the features. And then again, in the privacy section, you have something called motion and fitness. So here, if at all, like example, this is my internet service provider. So if you don't need this application to track your motion and fitness, definitely, which is not needed, you can turn it off. If at all you are a health related, person, then definitely you can give access to Nikron Club or health section. If not, you can just turn it off, which will prevent your phone to track your motion and fitness, and this will also help you have a good battery. And the next thing is also we have something called analytics and improvements. So which is again in the privacy section. Yeah, you can see here. So here what you can do is if at all you really need anything which is really needed here, now you can keep it, turn it, you know, you can just turn off. So usually what iPhone does is it shares the analytics with Apple, you know, if there is any glitch or something. So if you really don't want to share anything, and now you can just turn it off, which will again, you know, help you conserve your battery. So the next feature what I'm going to talk about is you can go to settings and go to App Store. So in the App Store we have something called app updates here. Okay, so you have something called automatic downloads. So if it is turned off, it is really good. If it is on, if you have a low battery, then it will really you know, consume a lot of battery. And even the app updates, right, if you give automatic downloads, then definitely it will download the apps automatically whenever you have a low battery, which will again you know, lead to a disaster. So what I would suggest is you just turn off the automatic app updates section here, and also keep the automatic downloads off, which will really help you. So this will help you conserve the battery. So the next thing is what I want to talk about is you know, a general thing. Okay, so settings. So usually when you are at home, I would suggest, you know, you really use Wi-Fi, because sometimes, you know, you have a lot of data from the service provider, and what happens is you tend to use the mobile data, not the Wi-Fi, because you have too much of data. So when you use your data from the Wi-Fi network, your battery consumption is very less compared to the LTE or, you know, non-Wi-Fi network. So I would really suggest you use Wi-Fi, which will lead to a good battery backup, and the power consumption will be less, and you will have a good battery backup. So the next thing is AirDrop. As you are all aware, we all use AirDrop a lot, right? So if you see, my AirDrop is set to everyone here, because I share my videos to my Mac and other stuff. So I would suggest you keep it as receiving off, which will really help you you know, conserve battery again. So only if it is when, you know, only when you need this, if you want to have some data transfer done to your Mac or any of the Apple devices, only then you can set it to contacts only. Or it depends if you are transferring some photos from any of the strangers, or, you know, who is not on your contacts, then you can set it to everyone. But I suggest you keep it as receiving off. This will really help you again gain some battery. Because the next thing is I will suggest you use you know, the dark mode, because dark mode you know, really helps you save a lot of battery, because the pixels get diluted. And, you know, dark mode is something really what we waited for a long time from Apple. So it's a very good feature. I will suggest you use dark mode, and this will really help you gain your power consumption, and it will help you save your battery. So the next thing is you go to settings and go to accessibility. So next, you something have called display and text size. So if you see here, you have something called auto brightness. If it is turned off, I suggest you turn it on, because turning off might affect your battery life. Because auto brightness is something, you know, when you are in a much lit room, the brightness of the phone will get reduced, and you will have some good battery there again. So whenever, you know, you are outside, probably you know, on a much sunny place or a sunny day, the brightness will get increased. So auto brightness is something, is a good feature, and you will have a good power consumption again. So the next feature is, like, you know, we usually open all of the applications here, like you saw. So don't close all the applications, because what happens is when you have certain applications open, like Instagram or Facebook or Safari, you know, it will not take much of a time to open again. So it will instantly open. If at all you close the apps, so it will take a lot of power to reopen back, and a lot of battery is consumed again. So I really suggest you do not close all the apps which you really use for a lot of time. So this will again help you save your battery. So these were some of the 25 tips and tricks what I wanted to share with you guys. So do subscribe my channel if you have come for the first time here. Also hit the like button. Do share it with your friends. So thank you for watching, guys. I'll probably catch up again on my next video. Till then, you guys take care. Bye bye.